What's going on, guys? Chad here with Greenlight Shooting, and welcome to a new review. So today we're talking about the Qipi belly band holster. Now, we've done a lot of belly bands on this channel because, quite frankly, they're popular. They're inexpensive, they conceal well, and people seem to like them. Qipi reached out to me and said, we saw some of your other videos and we think we might have the answer to some of your complaints. So let's take a look at this thing. I'll be honest, I've opened it, I've looked at the design, but I've never tried it. And this is really the first in-depth look I'm taking at this thing. So here we go, Qipi. You can kind of see the logo right there. The first thing that strikes me about this is every other belly band holster I've ever seen like this is this wide all the way through. This one, you can see they taper it down, and on their Amazon page, it says it's 30% less fabric, which is nice because it does cut down on costs for them, which means they can offer this at a little bit cheaper price. And it also is more breathable for us. You know, it's not all this heavy, unneeded fabric all the way around our body that's making us sweat more, etc. So I think that's a very, very welcome innovation there. Hard Velcro here, soft Velcro throughout the rest of the belt. Pretty standard stuff. Okay, let's talk about the part that matters. So this section here, this is definitely very reinforced. It's got a lot more rigidity. So we've got two pockets. We've got this one extra pocket, which if you've ever watched any of my videos, I don't understand what this pocket's for. I want this pocket on the other side and I don't want these little openings. This section is what we're really talking about. So their design for retention is on the top here, if you can see, is a button. There are a lot of holsters designed like that. So when you're drawing, you're intended to hit this with your thumb out and then draw the gun up. Now, I still feel like, I don't know why, I assume there's a reason that people haven't done this yet, but it seems like this should be flipped. Like you should hit the release on this side with your thumb so that your thumbs can stay on the left side of the gun. Right? So the gun's here, rather than having to unclip and then bring your thumb back over, why doesn't your thumb just hit a release right there as you're pulling up? I don't get that. Let's try this gun out. So this is a Springfield XDS 45 3.3 inch barrel. I've got the extended mag in there. Let me throw the non-extended in here for the purposes of this. Throw this in there. Does fit nicely. Kind of have to fish this thing out. Okay, so that's it in there. I've got this little tag hanging up. I need to take this up over top and button it. So there, you can see it there. If we were to flip this over, it does hold it pretty well, I have to admit. I thought that thing was gonna snap right off. So cool, it does have some good retention in there. This band comes all the way up over top. Is there, I think this can adjust actually. So on the bottom side of this strap is soft Velcro. On this little section is hard Velcro. So I think I can tighten or loosen this retention strap based on what gun I have in there. So there should be an easier way to do this. This is all sewed down. This just needs to like come up and like maybe a Velcro here and then a Velcro for this thing, because this is ridiculous. Okay. Okay, there's that. Now, the question is, how am I gonna get it back in here? Okay, what if I'm gonna slide it in upside down, right? Okay, so it slid in like that. Get it to where I want, which is there. So that's about where I want it. Now I'm gonna see if I can just flip this over. Haha! How's that for some ingenuity? Okay, so now we have an even a little bit tighter wrap around this thing. It's kind of interesting that it is now depressing the grip safety on the gun. Not great. So maybe the XDS isn't the most ideal gun for this. I mean, the trigger is completely covered, but if for some reason that trigger was able to pull, the grip is now depressed, which I'm not a huge fan of. Drawing this thing. So you can see what that looks like on top there. So I just need to flip that this way and then draw. So let's try that. We're gonna come here, drawing. Okay, so the button is very, very loose, and I actually like that. It's not something that requires a lot of force. It's literally a touch. We'll talk about this side pouch a little bit. I guess you can put an extra mag. But here's the thing with these. I mention this in every video, but there's one little sew like right down the middle there, so I can't like fully get a mag in there. It's too small for a gun. I want this to be an extra mag slot that is hard Velcro on the bottom to soft Velcro that you can move around. I have no clue what this pocket's for, ever. Okay, enough griping. Let's try this thing on and see how it actually works. I think I'm gonna wear this at appendix carry for the sake of this video.
So, there we go. Let's put the gun in here for all the skeptics out there.
Okay, there it is. The good thing about belly bands is they really do conceal pretty well. I mean, this is like a really thin summer shirt with some shorts, and it's conceals fairly well. I mean, it's printing a little bit if I go like this, but I don't think it's anything that someone's gonna say, you're carrying a gun, you know what I mean? You know, the top of this should probably come in line with the top of your pants. Now, let's see how this thing actually draws. So I'm gonna do it half speed first. So, boom. Boom, boom. Pretty smooth, not bad. Reholstering isn't terrible. I will admit that it's significantly cooler than most belly bands, as I mentioned, with that, like, you know, 30% less fabric all the way around. Like, I don't really feel like I'm wearing a belly band, which is pretty cool. And draw a little bit faster. I'm looking over here, I'm not gonna look down. Oh, okay, so I obviously need to tighten my belt a little bit or something there, but wasn't a super clean job, but it would work. One thing I will say is this little retention strap is a fairly small target. I think you'd have to practice with it pretty often to be able to hit it, you know, with absolutely no looking, no concentration, just clip it and go. Again, I'm not a huge fan of flipping my thumb this way and then bringing it back. It's just an extra motion. It's not the end of the world, but you know, it is something if we're being nitpicky here. That little target thing, I think that is something you can get over. As I mentioned, with a little bit of practice, I think you can find that pretty easily. But in a high stress situation, it's hard to say. Okay, so there you have it. The Qipi belly band holster. Pros about it. Number one, just like every other belly band holster, it's very comfortable and it does conceal very well. I really like this thinner profile. It's very, the inside lining is fairly breathable. It feels pretty similar to what most of the other belly bands are like, but just the fact that this is so much thinner really is more noticeable than I thought it would be. And the draw is fairly clean. You know, it's really not that bad. Negatives, things I think they can improve on it. Number one is this pouch. Like, Let me move it, let me do something, let me add extra mags, I don't know. Moving on to this section, number one I'd say is this. Just like, give me a snap here, let me open this, adjust this, and then snap it back down. Or a Velcro or something like that for quick adjustments. If I'm switching guns daily or something like that, I don't want to deal with this thing every time. Next up is this retention style on an XDS is depressing the grip safety, which bothers me. I know that's gun specific, but you know, XDS is a pretty popular gun. Next up is, I don't know if it's possible, but if possible, just flip this. Like, let me keep my thumb on the left side of the gun so I can push down and then draw without having to move my thumb back and forth. And this, because I'm having to grab something and flip it rather than just being able to push down on my gun and pull up, I have to find this target. And this target is, like I said, about an inch. I don't know, it's relatively small. And in a high stress situation, I think that could be somewhat of a fumble to try and find. So I would love to see that, I don't know, lengthened or like, maybe you could just lengthen this side up a little bit more or make it, you know, just kind of a big little something that pops up that's like really, really hard to miss. Like your entire thumb could just go in and hit it. Like you don't have to, you know, have some dexterity to try and flip that open. Yeah, another positive I forgot to mention though is this button. I do like how it's just so simple to flip. It's not really difficult. It's not something you have to have two hands to open. It really does respond well to just a flick. Okay, so that's the Qipi belly band belt holster. Overall, honestly, I think it's a really good design. I really do. I'm being nitpicky just because I've reviewed so many of these that, you know, I have some expectations out of them. So again, I'm not a huge fan of the retention in general on these. I think the retention from the belt itself is enough to hold it in place. But if you're someone who really does like that retention, this is another good option. If they made those changes, this would be an absolutely fantastic option. Definitely stay away from the ones that require you to stick your thumb down in your pants somewhere and find a button or a hook or something. Those are garbage. This is great that it keeps everything above the belt to open up. Draw's clean, belt's good. Best part about it is it's $16.99, so it's really, really inexpensive. Honestly, I'm a big fan of them. I think they're doing things right. They're moving in the right direction. Let's put it that way. So I'm gonna give them one thumbs up rather than two, but definitely a thumbs up. So anyways, that's the Qipi Belly Band Belt Holster. I hope you enjoyed. Go check them out. The link to their Amazon page is down in the video description below. And yeah, thanks so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. See you next time on Greenlight Shooting.